Akira looks amazing 35 years later. Akira is an anime film based on the manga of the same name. Released in 1988, the movie was directed by Katsuhiro Otomo, who is also the mangaka of the manga. I gotta say that this man is a madman, as he didn't even finish the story of Akira before making the movie. It follows our protagonist Kaneda and his life in Neo Tokyo 30 years after an explosion. This wiped out the entire city of Tokyo. We see the government are trying an experiment on individuals to make them gain psychic powers. This goes wrong and Kaneda's friend is taken away and experimented on. The movie is visually stunning for the time, and knowing a lot of these scenes were drawn frame by frame, it just adds to how much effort was put into this. Before we start, spoiler warning for a 35-year-old film, and don't forget to like and subscribe. It really does help the channel and your support is always appreciated. Let's just jump straight into it. Start with a flashback to 1988 Tokyo, when a huge explosion occurs that destroys a huge chunk of Tokyo. We later find out this was caused by Akira. We move to Neo Tokyo, set in 2019, 31 years after World War III. The title rolls and we move to a bar. On the TV, we see riots occurring. We are introduced to our main protagonist, Kaneda. We get word of a rival biker gang in the area, so the crew get ready to chase. We meet Tetsuo, who will later be a problem for us. Kaneda races off in his badass bike, as we see the future of Tokyo. Some poor soul gets his car totaled by those damn clown bikers. A chase ensues with destruction following them both. Kaneda confronts one of the big grunts with a bike joust. He obviously wins, and we see the iconic Akira bike slide reference in so much media. The police come and the gang escape. We see a man pulling along with a kid that seems to be very old and very wrinkly and very blue. He ends two dogs chasing him, and this is just a tease at how violent the film gets later on. The riot passes by and the duo are caught by the police. The man is bleeding while protecting the kid. We are also introduced to Ryu. The man fires shots and is met with a rain of bullets. He dies in the wildest way, but the kid loses it and destroys the block and what we assume is using his psychic powers. The kid vanishes into thin air and we meet another kid along with the colonel. On the other side of things, Kaneda and Tetsuo are still chasing the clowns, but Tetsuo goes further. He ends up crashing by the blue kid and is badly injured. The government come and take the kid and Tetsuo away. Kaneda and the gang are at the police station and are interrogated, but the police are fooled by their act and let them go. Kaneda sees Kei in the room and convinces the cops to let her go. He tries to get information from her, but she escapes him. We see the colonel in a meeting and soon after, Tetsuo being tested on. The professor shows the colonel that Tetsuo is very similar or close to being similar to Akira and his powers in 1988. They continue tests on Tetsuo and try to make him more powerful. The colonel worries if they'll be able to control Tetsuo if he gets too powerful. We are now at the gang school and they get disciplined. We move to the facility where we see Tetsuo escaping to find Kaori. They talk about what's going on and Tetsuo wants to run away far away with her. This leads to him stealing Kaneda's bike while he's at school. The rival gang sees this and chases after him. The bike stalls and the rival gang beats up Tetsuo and Kaori. Kaneda comes just in time and fights them. Tetsuo beats up one of the guys to the brink of death while complaining Kaneda is always saving him. We see the Akira meme and he gets visions of what's to come in the future. We see visions of the floor caving in and his guts spilling out. The migraines continue as the government come and give him medicine and take him away. We are at some entertainment center when a huge explosion occurs. We see Kei running away and Kaneda notices. Ryu and Kei are trying to infiltrate the facility. Kaneda follows Kei and saves her from the police. From here, we flash back to some of Tetsuo's past as everything gets destroyed around him, including himself. This is actually a nightmare and he freaks out. We meet another experiment who tells us that she had a dream of destruction in the future and that many people will die and that they will meet Akira. To prevent all of this, the boy Tetsuo must not be released. The colonel heads to the area that is holding Akira. It seems to be a cryogenic chamber. Kaneda and Kei are confronted by Ryu and the rest accused him of being a spy and is locked in a room. As the group discuss their new plan, Kaneda overhears and wants to help. They feel he would be a good decoy. Ryu talks to some businessman who we will see later on is a higher politician, and he says that people will catch on about Akira and shows kills the people in a cult that believe Akira will save them. Politics rise and we see powerful people in a room talk about experiments and Akira. The colonel worries about another Akira incident. Back to Tetsuo in his room and we see a glimpse of his psychic abilities. Ryu, Kei, and Kaneda sneak into the facility as repairmen. While this happens, Tetsuo hallucinates some toys coming to life. They grow massive and attack Tetsuo. While he fights for his life, the car just lets go on him and he sees it as milk. In the struggle, he cuts his foot and the kids are shown to be behind this whole thing. They retreat as they don't like the sight of blood. Tetsuo escapes, drooling at the mouth. He is confronted by security and scientists but swiftly eliminates them. An alarm sounds while we see Kaneda and the gang sneak in the sewers. They get caught by a patrol vehicle. Kaneda does some sick moves and acquires the vehicle, escaping with Kei into the facility. Meanwhile, Tetsuo is fighting off all the guards with ease and destroying everything in his path. He makes it to the kids' room and confronts all three of them. They try fighting him but fail as he's getting too strong. The one kid gives him information on Akira and Tetsuo wants to find him. Kaneda and Kei make it to Tetsuo but Tetsuo is too cocky with his power and feels superior to Kaneda. Kaneda challenges him but Tetsuo just shows off his immense power. He finds out that Akira is under the Olympic Stadium that is being built and heads there by flying. The colonel is confronted outside, being told his position is revoked, but in a situation like this, we can't just be doing stuff like this. He shows him that there are bigger things to worry about and leaves. Tetsuo heads back to the bar, but this time he kills the bartender, and later Yamagata. Kaneda and Kei are locked up, but the kids assist them in escaping. We get more information on Akira. He is apparently limitless energy. Trying to control Akira's power led to the explosion in 1988. Kaneda and Kei escape and meet with Mitsuru. Kaneda crashes Yamagata's bike as a tribute to him. As this happens, one of the kids take away Kei and to try and help them stop Tetsuo. A coup occurs and the executives are arrested. We see the politician from earlier trying to take all his money and run away while fighting a heart attack. Ryu enters and is shot by him. However, they both don't get too far as they both die in the same alleyway. The army is in the streets as they try fend off Tetsuo. He acquires a red cloth and uses it as a cape. The Akira activists join in on the celebration as they think this is Akira. Tetsuo is too powerful as he can stop a tank bullet right in front of him. Kayuri sees Tetsuo on the news and follows the crowd. As this happens, Kaneda gets his bike and confronts Tetsuo. The army uses laser guns that seem to be effective against Tetsuo, but he destroys the entire bridge, killing hundreds. He approaches the facility that is holding Akira and opens the capsule. To everyone's surprise, Akira is not in there, but his sliced up brain is. It is said that the technology and science was not advanced enough back then, so the government preserved Akira's brain for the future to study. Kei is there possessed by the kid, trying to stop Tetsuo. Kaneda arrives using one of those laser guns to fight Tetsuo. They have some banter between each other, but they seem somewhat evenly matched. Kaneda nearly hits Tetsuo with a fatal blow, but the battery runs out. However, Soul is activated and targets Tetsuo. This damages him badly, where he loses an arm. He is hit again, but this time he flies into space and destroys Soul. But before that, he rains down shots, destroying everything around him. Kaneda and Kei escape, and Tetsuo makes a new arm made of metal. The kids plan to do something when his power is at his peak. The colonel sees that the professor is hiding information on Akira, and we see the machine go crazy. The gangs are preparing to fight Tetsuo, and this time bringing more batteries. Kayori finds Tetsuo at the stadium and brings him to the throne. Here, his powers grow stronger as the medicine controlling him weakens. The colonel is in the stadium, ready to confront Tetsuo. The colonel is pushed back, but he shoots Tetsuo, weakening his control further. His arm is now a fleshy mess of metal and flesh. He tries to kill the colonel, but Kaneda saves him. Kaneda fights him, but is saved by the kid. Tetsuo loses control and devolves into a huge fleshy monster, consuming everything in its path. He begs for help as he is in pain. The flesh grabs Kayori and Kaneda. We see Kayori die, getting crushed as Tetsuo begs for help. Kaneda escapes the flesh using the laser gun, but then continues to grow. The kids are nearly consumed, but they release Akira and we see what Akira looks like. At this point, Akira's immense energy creates an explosion identical to the one from 1988. This damages Tetsuo, reverting him slowly. The kids save the colonel by placing him far away. Kaneda feels Tetsuo can be saved, but the kids try to stop him. Kaneda is taken into the light, but the kids band together to save him, knowing that they may not be able to escape themselves. We see a massive explosion consume Neo Tokyo. At the same time, we see flashbacks of Tetsuo's past with Kaneda. Kaneda is experiencing his memories. We see him also experience Akira's memories as they test him and the other experiments. It's shown that the kids were man-made and not born like that. Kaneda is saved and we see the destruction of the city. A small white orb descends as Kaneda mourns Tetsuo. The gang leaps towards a better life. We see a visual of what seems to be Tetsuo as energy and the credits roll. This movie still makes me squeamish at the scene where Tetsuo loses control. I absolutely love the art art style and animation, and would have really appreciated the movie if I watched it in cinemas back then. The sounds just make it feel like a sci-fi thriller too, with mystery surrounding Akira and what the government wants to achieve. The animation looks so fluid and smooth, and it gives off a weird feeling since the movie looks so old at the same time. I will review the direction, story, animation and sound and give my opinion and rating at the end. Regarding the direction, the movie transitions a lot between Tetsuo and Kaneda in the same scene, and then having the two meet up again at the climaxes. It can get a bit confusing at times, but you catch on in a few minutes or later. I feel as if most of the scenes are there to just set up the climax and build up a conclusion. We are usually seen in a dark lit area, being lit up with only artificial light. It could be to show the contrast at the end climax when everything is taken up by the white light, showing a new beginning. After that, most of the scenes are well lit in the daytime. I also gotta mention that there were minimal flashbacks. This isn't necessarily a bad thing. It only gets bad if it's placed in a weird part of the movie. The direction is good and good choices were made. The entire story revolves around Kaneda and Tetsuo with a taste of Akira. The concept of Tokyo being destroyed by the government trying to control and replicate the power all these years later is good, and it shows the greed for power that some officials have. And that's just another theme we see where the government wants more power. It could be the cause of why World War 3 started after the Akira incident. I enjoyed the story and will definitely read the manga one day. The animation was so good for the time. I can see why it gained a cult following at the time. My favorite scene will always be Tetsuo becoming a fleshy mess, as that entire scene was so smooth and fluid. The lasers and blood mechanics are what you would expect, but they still look very nice, as sometimes they are the brightest items in the scene. The facial expressions are amazing, as we as the viewer feel the same way. And lastly, the sound. The bike chases, the tire screeches feel as if there's so much speed and power behind them. We get glimpses of eerie noises like the bike when they get caught. The sound effects do scratch something in my brain. Let's not forget that the soundtrack, it's mainly a deep type of music, giving the feeling of danger and uncertainty. It fits the theme very well. In all honesty, I hope one day they remake Akira and adapt the entire manga, because if this what was done in 1988, then I can't imagine what they would do in the future. I give this anime a solid 9 out of 10. It was amazing on all fronts and loses a point mainly by switching scenes too often. What do you guys think? Leave your thoughts and any facts about the film in the comments section below. Don't forget to like, as it really helps the channel, and subscribe if you would like to see more anime reviews just like this. It's your boy ZenMasterKai. Take care and